Good evening on Tuesday.
Tuesday the 7th
of April 2020. COVID time. So,
let's see.
Again, if you're coming in.
I think we're live.
Right, so. Welcome along, folks, to Meitheal Ceol, your online daily sing-song for the soul. A place where...
This is me, isn't it?
Yeah, that's fine.
Say hello.
So we're just checking again. I have to check our sound is with us here.
Good evening. All.
Stabilise my stand there. And... So you're welcome once again. Again, I suppose we choose to do this at 7 o'clock every evening, just to allow us to escape a little bit from the drudgery and the bad news. In Ireland, just there now, had the highest number, almost a double number of deaths, sadly, today than we've had yesterday. So I think all of us are in no doubt. We think. Of the situation pertaining to Boris Johnson in England, who's in intensive care. So we realise that, as I say, this virus knows no colour, doesn't respect orange or green or black or white or Asian or Caucasian, old or young. Just listened to a young nurse on the radio there who has contracted it, really requesting people to, you know, again, maintain the only known protocol we have is staying physically distant with each other, to each other, which leaves us all, as we experience ourselves, all incarcerated away in our own homes, etc. And also coming up to Easter Sunday and Easter weekend, and the weather here is getting a bit brighter in Ireland. People are probably feeling a bit pressurised being indoors, etc. So anyway, what we're going to do, hopefully, is sing together. And again, this is the important thing about this is that this exercise here is an exercise for us all to sing together. We're going to provide you with words of songs. We're going to, hopefully, that you'll join us and play along with. I mean, that's the essence of this exercise here. You'll see songs. And we sing them out of our two song books. Again, if this is your first time here, you're welcome. We'll talk you through how to get the book, etc. later on. Again, if it's your first time listening to us, please do comment in the commentary there, because Mary here beside me will look at, we can see the comments coming in on her phone.
So
and
Paul
like to
Flaherty
say hello.
Is here already from Cork, or originally from Cove. We have Sheila McMahon. We've got Anya. Anya's internet is back after being away for 2 days. She said she really missed us. Louis Brown is watching from Sussex, I think. Ray Atchison is watching. John Coyle, hello. Kathy Anderson and Peter and Paul. Nancy is here from Nashville. Nancy Paulus. And we have Natalie from West Germany. Nigel O'Mahony and Vivian.
So guys, we're coming from all sorts of parts of the world in all sorts of time zones. Again, our weather here today has been a bright, bright and breezy, still a bit cold, etc. And I spent my day just, when I worked on the railway, a friend of mine, John Brown, used to say, the harder we work here, the faster we move the whole around the garden. So I spent a day like this, trying to contact the Samsung support system to help me commission a television, and just a disaster, a complete and absolute disaster. I searched everywhere for, I was trying to use the AirPlay feature where I can flip my iPad's content directly up onto a screen, which is available on many new smart TVs, etc. It was just a disaster trying to do this, and also to tune in some satellite station, just get it to recognize the satellite receiver. So
Joe Kane is here.
I'm certainly ready for a few tunes to get ahead of this, having a nice cup of tea here at the moment.
Just
the reason, by the way, I was hopefully there's a friend of mine, Sean Lawless, from Dundalk, you might be listening tonight again. Sean was probably, I was probably shouting down the phone at Sean as he was pointing his phone at his PC to try and see how to get into Facebook. While I was frustrated trying to get my own TV to work. So anyway, you got in there, Sean. I hope you're with us. And again,
Sean's quite involved. Let us know if you are, Sean, please, yeah?
Yeah, well, I hope you mightn't recognise how to use the common thing, but listen along and watch and you'll watch and learn. But again, Sean will be very active supporting people with dementia and Alzheimer's, perhaps in creating an environment where people in nursing homes and isolated with Alzheimer's knows who love music gets access to this. So that's why I was experimenting with putting this up on a TV.
So Ray Byrne says, looking forward to another session. He likes Galway Girl. We're not doing Galway Girl tonight. I don't think so. Oh, we have a Galway Girl. We have Galway Girl for tonight.
Here, guys, look.
We haven't practiced. I put this up. I have
already put it up. You can't read that unless you're dyslexic.
Now, the only problem with that
we have a number of songs here. So they were, Mary put them up in an earlier post.
We haven't practiced
and anyway, look, it's an indication of where we go with these songs. We're delighted if people look in beforehand. We give you some idea. I think, Joe Kane, you were in contact with Mary, but did he send you some list
of
songs?
Well, no, but I'm waiting. Who sent me some? Natalie sent me some songs from West Germany. She loves the Irish music. And Anya New York from London, she also sent some songs. So we're waiting for you there, Joe.
Okay, so look at excellent, guys. What we're asking is out of the 500 or so songs that are in the two PDFs of books, which we encourage you to download, you download them by clicking on clicking like the Meitheal Ceol page, visit the group, join the group, and in there you get access to the PDFs of the two books. So look, there's no point in asking for songs that are not there. We hardly know the ones that are there at the
moment. So we have Ray Atchison and Ray Byrne, and then Louis says Suffolk, not Sussex. There must be a difference. I thought England was all the same, no matter where you were.
Norfolk and Suffolk.
Norfolk.
I know those two places.
We do. We've had really
nice.
Every
time I go to England, I just get on a motorway and go to wherever I go. I have no idea. I have some idea of the geography of Ireland, and I know where Wales and Cornwall and Devon are, but I get lost when I get over to the Hull or something like that.
Oh, what about,
although many of the songs we sing actually mention a lot of
towns. We have a very nice song that we're going to do one of these nights. What's it called?
The Dalesman's Litany.
Lovely
song.
Beautiful song.
So we're going to start off with a song, and it was Daydream Believer. Let's say, Mary said we should start off with a bit of a happy song.
Fast one anyway.
So we're going to play this in the capo position on fret 2. And we see how that goes. Again, a lot of time we have to try and work it on a night where we're going to play these as it fits. I know you'd be better swiveling a wee bit. No, swiveling a bit like this.
Like this,
We're trying to stick ourselves into a very narrow footprint determined by to the iPad. It's not that we can't fit into the picture, but I have to lean forward here and where's the camera? Somewhere along there. I have to change things on. So what you're looking at is a screen capture of my iPad, so as I square across, you're looking at different apps that I'm using. So I'm using Daydream, using this in the Adobe Acrobat app. So you'd have to apologize, I'll have to stop throughout the song to do this. Anyway, let's go and have a bit of fun, right? So the whole thing here is sing along, you love this song.
Hello, again. Annie McDermott.
Why could I need the wings of the bluebird as she sings? 6 o'clock alarm would never ring. I could break, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. Shaving razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean? Daydream believer and a homecoming queen. Oh, you once thought me as a white knight on the sea. Now you know how happy I can be. Oh, our good time started then with a daughter. Sleepy Jean,
what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen?
I think that's it, Jim.
Oh yeah, that's it. Very short, really, isn't it? We should have practiced that.
Anyway, look, there's no point of shoulda, woulda, coulda in this world anymore. That. Mary feels.
On your work,
Mary does confession very well here.
On your work, sort of. She doesn't mind whether we practice it or not. She just enjoys it.
We don't mind either.
I hope you're singing along there.
Hey, we're too busy doing nothing to be have the time to practice. We are on a promise someday.
The monkeys.
But I'm laughing a bit at that one because. That really started off as if you're pushing a bicycle. It started really slow as you're pushing the bicycle. I don't know. The next exploration. So look, we're in a time of learning, folks. Hopefully learning new songs, a bit of fun, learn to meet new people, learn to live in new ways, exist, survive, whatever. So promise is to learn something about timing and cadence. And I am actively exploring metronomes and all sorts of other devices where I can
get
my time
really
and
confused, So, who was the lead singer with the Monkees? Was it Mickey Dolenz?
Mickey Dolenz, is that
Mickey Dolenz, Mickey Dolenz.
I have his name, Dave D, Dozy, Beaky, Mickey and Titch. I don't know where it comes from,
Mickey.
But it's in the back of my head.
On in
New
York,
you know.
You'll know that. I see that you like that one.
So here's, I would be delighted if you do a couple of things. Firstly, I know from talking to Sean Lawless today, he's been interested in the what's going on in this sort of thing. And I was pointing out to him that we like to sing birthday greetings for people at 8 o'clock. So if you know anybody who's got a birthday, just a big shout out to Alan Byrne's mother. He forgot to tell me it was her birthday 2 days ago. Would have loved to have sang a song to her. She was 93. She's in a nursing home in Dublin.
Yeah.
And the benevolent nursing home, I think, on the north side. So again, I reach out to you. But if you have got a birthday or a greeting you'd like to send someone through this medium, please do. And very much so, the other thing is to share this stream live. Just press the share button and send it to
family and friends and
whatever. So, but the idea is like, certainly, thankfully I wasn't too listening too carefully to the news tonight because I was trying to sort out some other techie sort of thing, and I wasn't listening too close. But I was glad it wasn't the only thing I had to do today is listen to this, because it's desperate. I mean, they're not, you know, the sort of doom and gloom element of it is not nice to watch. So look, at people might enjoy getting out of their heads a little bit for a while, and that's all this is about.
So Joe Kane says, "Hi Mary, that list was sent on Messenger around 10 a.m. this morning."
Yeah, but I don't think the list came with it. Yeah, I'm not sure, Joe, that the list came with it, by the way. Just I saw the message, but I didn't see any list with it. So maybe you might just check
again. I think
again.
He's maybe talking about...
Willie
us.
Pierce, are we on tonight?
Were we asked? We're on every night, actually.
I don't know how you can answer him.
We've written this in a message to you.
Nobody's calling Messenger. Look, I don't want to go in there. Hopefully, Willie will keep in. So essentially, insofar, a bit of a problem. I forgot my Facebook password again tonight. It was a 5 to 7, trying to reset a password thing. But
so
our objective is trying to be here every night at 7. I said, none of us have anywhere to be going at 7 o'clock unless it's online somewhere. So that's what we're going to try and do over there. And if you don't get a chance to listen to it at 7, come back later on and listen.
So it was Mickey Dolenz, Davy Jones, Mike Nesbitt, ? And Pete somebody or other.
Mike D, Dozy, Beaky, Mickey and Tit. So
there's
something of those names. I was a kid, I just knew those names. Didn't even know who they were. It was before I was even old enough to be able to buy singles. I would have heard other people who are older than me talking about these things.
Leaving of Liverpool.
So we're going to move to the Leaving of Liverpool.
Page 379, book 1. For anybody who has a book.
So what we do is just explain how the book works. And again, I'd encourage you to download the book to just for yourself to have fun and with these books. Like, it's a wonderful tool to have going forward is a song book that you can get and sing. And, you know, I think in this period of COVID, we're going to learn lots of things to do that we've maybe forgotten about in the past and be able to rely. All you need to sing a song is if you have the words in front of you and a few chords and belt away with it, you know.
Here's Nigel O'Mahony saying, "The Legend of Xanadu was the big hit of Dave D. Dozy McIntosh." Peter Torp.
how Dave D. Dozy, Pete, Mickey and Titch, is it? Petey, maybe it's Petey. Sorry, I don't know. I have this term, Beaky. Anyway, listen, let's go for this.
The Seven Dwarfs, yeah.
Don't even know deliver. Who did deliver Leaving of Liverpool?
Oh, we'll be told.
I keep thinking it's the Clancy Brothers, but it may have been as well, but lots of other people, probably Johnny McAvoy did them, etc. But again, it's a lovely song. We can remember how to sing. We're playing it open, guys, anyway, all right? So join in. Again, the whole exercise here is for you to join in, have a bit of fun with it. If you have an instrument, take it out and play. If you haven't practiced around for a while, you can, never mind making mistakes, just have a go. And you can always play these back if you like these songs and keep practicing if you have time. And we've all got time on our hands, guys, all right?
Yeah.
I mean, maybe some of you are very good at tidying up the house and doing all the stuff you should have done years ago. We haven't got around to that yet.
Just making a bigger mess at the moment.
Fair. Farewell to you, my own true love. I am going far, far away. I am bound for California, and an island I'll return someday. So fare thee well, my own true love. And when I return,
it's not the leaving of Liverpool that brings
So we don't, did we do find out who sang that song?
Yeah, let's see. The Clancy Brothers and Tommy Makem, the best.
All right, yeah. So again,
two different groups there.
Mm-hmm.
Teresa Laverty is watching. Teresa is from Stranorlar. And Joe Kane and Teresa and Nigel. He said, we forgot Beaky.
Well, that's what I thought. Beaky. Dave D. Dozy, Beaky, Mickey and Titch, mm-hmm. I presume.
Yeah.
Just sending Willie Pierce a message there. What's the next song? The next song we set out to do is Black is the Colour, so let's see how that works out here. So again, let us know how, that's another thing we can do, is just let us know how your weather is in all your different locations today.
Sheila said, beautiful day in Dundalk, beautiful and sunny.
Yeah, I think it was talking to someone in Dublin today, and I said to one of the increasing wonders for me is that when you're physically isolated, wherever you are, and all of us are, it makes you wonder, are any of the other parts of the world actually real or not? Are they a fabrication of our imagination? I'm not sure. And only for, if you're talking to someone who is elsewhere and to tell you things, keep sort of reminding you that you're connected to a wider world. You know, in a world where you've had all these networks, but there were physical networks and that people were physically able to connect with each other. I might meet somebody who's down in Dublin today or somebody flown in from Glasgow or whatever. Increasingly, we don't even meet people who are down to town today. So that's the reality. So it's a great way. That's why I suppose when we did a live stream originally, our history was we were a group of people who just sang together on a Wednesday night in the men's shed down Scubo Navarre in Gweedore on the North Atlantic, on the Wild Atlantic Way in Donegal in Ireland, and we'd sit around a table on a Wednesday night and just play together for fun. Mm. And all of that has been restricted because of COVID-19. So what we're looking at is a way in which we can try and emulate that same sort of sing-song experience. So it depends very much on you. And again, I was talking to another friend of mine today. He said, it's a bit weird trying to, I can't hear you, as he said. I can hear you, but nobody can hear me or the other people. Mm. And that's true. And that's one of the restrictions of the time delays or latency in the internet. And that's true. But I will say that I read an article about how many people are doing exercises in front of the TV now with Joe, some guy, Joe, somebody who does Pilates and yoga and all that stuff. And people are going, I must increase my bust, whatever. They're doing those exercises in front of the TV and then they're having a bit of laugh with each other. So like we're learning to throw away some of the inhibitions we had. So if you ever had inhibitions about dancing naked in the woods or anything like that, these things
go
are
on
probably,
out and do it. Just take off your clothes.
Well, you can't go out, but you can.
Down, you can go
in front of the TV.
You can go so, skinny dipping down here. And Natalie said,
in a barrel of water, and you can
Natalie
go skinny
said,
dipping.
It's a beautiful day in West Germany. It's actually 20 degrees where she is. 20 degrees, imagine. Mm-hmm.
Well, we're a good bit away from 20 degrees at the moment, but look at,
sure
as if it's a said it could be worse. We're going to go on to Scarborough, no, Black is the Colour, sorry, and the Black of the Colour, that's the one we're doing now, isn't it? Black is the Colour.
Black
so
the
again,
color,
you just go back, over all this is hyperlinked, you click on the index button, it brings you back to the first track, the index page, you just go through these. Again, you know, problem with all these, I remember these songs, is the range in the song, wherever you start. So I have to play around here to find out where I think we can
work.
Oh,
you said it's a beautiful day in London, but here's somebody now. Kevin and Erica Gallagher. That was good. Miss the strumming pattern for that song. Only learning here. So where's here? Tell us where here is, please.
I wouldn't be very good in the strumming patterns or anything like that, and we wouldn't want to be judged too carefully. We're not trying to get into the Philharmonic Orchestra here, but look, it battered away to whatever it is. At some point in this whole journey, I will presumably learn to understand what a matter, whatever. But it's all about having a bit of fun and just making a bit of noise and joining along. Wouldn't it be great if I had those other skills as well? But anyway.
So the person who does the exercise on the television is Joe Wicks for seniors.
Joe Wicks for seniors.
That's what I'm told here.
I think all sorts of people are doing these. But anyway, look, we're learning new skills and cultural behavioural patterns, etc. So why not learn to sing along? What we do is put the music up in front of you and the words and give you a general gist of what's going on here. So I worry that they'll run out of steam on this, of height with this. But anyway, we'll try it all more we know. Black is the colour of my true love's hair. Her lips are like some roses fair. She's the sweetest smile and the gentlest hands. I love the ground. I love my love and the world she knows. I love the ground whereon she goes. I wish the day it soon would come when she and I I go to the Clyde where I mourn and weep. For satisfied I never will be. I write her a letter, just a few short lines, and suffer death, though a thousand. Winter's past and the leaves are green. The time has passed that we have seen, but still I hope the time will come when she and I will be as one.
So black.
Black is the colour of my true love's hair. Her lips are like some roses fair. She's the sweetest smile and the gentlest hands. I love the ground she stands. So who's that last chap who contacted you and said he was learning?
Yeah, just one little moment. No, that's boom, boom, boom.
So a lot of messages coming in the comments. Please come and bring them in the comments. You can't see these. It doesn't turn up on the screen in front of us. But Mary can see them on her phone.
I'll find them. So Kevin Berica Gallagher.
Kevin De Burke, is it now?
No.
Berica, not Gallagher. Well, yeah, so Kevin, I mean, I think you said that you were a learner or a beginner. That's right,
yeah.
So you're really welcome. And what we really think about this space is, as you'll hear from our performance or whatever, the threshold of acceptability here is quite low. The only stable part of all of this is that we're all singing the same words and the same chords. And we'll tell you where to put the capo on the guitar or mandolin or ukulele or whatever you're playing. And again, I think if you like any of these songs, there's 500 songs in the book, there'll be lots of songs you like. I mean, my recommendation to anybody in this time is to aspire to learning a certain number of songs. And in fact, we're just going to move it every 7:30 every evening, just to explain to you. And we take a particular song and we're going to sing it for 7 days. We're on our fourth day singing this song. So that everybody can say, I know that song after 7 days. After 4 weeks, you'll know four songs. Four absolute songs that you can say, if ever I meet up with any of these people, you can just sing together or sing in your own groups, etc. So some people may say, I could learn 10 songs a day. That's great. That's not a problem. But I'm just saying, for someone who might have tried to play before and didn't have the motivation or didn't stick ability or whatever, this is something you can actually do.
Yeah.
So the one we're doing is the Jug of Punch.
Maria Fordham said that was a lovely song. And Bella Dugan says she, Dennis and Pauline are listening in tonight.
Excellent.
Paul Griffin is here as well.
So again, you're all welcome, guys. But again, I hope now that if you're there in twos or threes, don't be afraid to give it a lash and sing to your heart's content, because there's nothing as good, we found anyway, as to lift the spirits when you're singing songs yourself, as against it being done to you. So this is not, if you're relying on us to raise your level of consciousness or ease your the pain or whatever you're experiencing, it's really, it'll come from within. So you really have to sing along. That's really what it's about. It's not a judgment, but it's an invitation for you. And again, if you have an instrument, to have a go to work. What are we doing now?
We're doing, oh, so we're going to do Scarborough Fair, I think.
All right, so we'll try Scarborough Fair. And again, the other thing is, hopefully, we try and respond to it. Out of date now, there's no point in asking us for songs that are not in this book, as you can see. There's a lot of learning for us in the ones that are in the book, and to play them and sing them.
Keelan, you're welcome. So, Keelan O'Donnell, you're welcome.
How are you, Keelan? So again,
we watch you too, Keelan, and you're doing extremely well every night. With
so again, Keelan's one of the. So again, say hello to Keelan there. People should say hello to each other through the stream, because in a way we are a group of people, a common community of interest, I suppose, through this whole period. And Keelan used to play along with us when we all played in Letterkenny. Last night we had Brian Laverty and Cal McGlynn, I think, was in. But, you know, we used to go there on a Thursday night and play together. And this was the period when we started putting this book together. And again, Keelan, I saw you singing a song out of the book. The other, oh, it was Sam Stone, I think. I saw you sing the other night.
And Sunday Morning Coming Down, you did extremely well.
That's right.
Too.
So, we know your practice in a way, which isn't it great? I mean, when you came first, you were a bit shy to sing and play, and isn't it wonderful you're putting stuff out there? So that's what it's about.
So
really,
Mary O'Gogan is here as well. Mary with a beautiful voice, and Anne, also her twin, has a beautiful voice. And we have, just one moment now, we have Maria Fordham, who says, having a learning song for a week is a good idea. Okay.
Well, that's what we were supposed to be doing. Sorry, guys. When I was so rudely interrupted,
lost our slot there. You asked me what we were supposed to be doing, you just forgot, actually.
That's right. So at 7:30, we're trying to do this every night at 7:30. So the song we're doing is the Jug of Punch. And I'm trying to work with great difficulty to get some different medium of expressing this music. Oh my God, 154, I think we're trying to do this. So I'm trying to set up a scrolling system where the song will play in front of us and just scroll along the screen at an approximate speed. So you can see what it's going to do. The song is going to come up here.
Joe Kane, I thought you didn't like the Jug of Punch. You're getting to like it, are you?
Anyway, I know it doesn't matter what song we sing. Some might like it, some people won't. It's not really about that. It's just to give everybody a focus. Say, yeah, we achieved this after that period of time, and particularly for that chap Kevin who's just on there now, I certainly think that for me, having an instrument and leaving it lying around and not getting around to a bit of focus didn't help. So any opportunity to practice it, and we have the opportunity, this is something different on trying to work out the answers to the meaning of life.
That's so Ray McCarthy, you're very welcome here. Not sure if you've been here before or not.
Yeah, Ray's been here, and I think Ray's in Patricia Brandy's ukulele group, Scary. So plenty of those opportunities, I'm sure, a lot of us to practice these. Yeah. Okay, we start off. It's going to be
Rob is here,
just follow
Glasgow.
The chords that are on the screen, no capo. Okay, let's go. One pleasant evening in the month of June, I lay sleeping in my room, a small bird sang Turn a loo, turn a loo, turn a loo, turn a loo, turn a loo.
bird sang on an ivy bush, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. It got very bad, and wasn't able to go or stand. I would not think at all to miss a pledge, oh my shoes for red jug of punch. A small bird sang on an ivy bush, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. Let the doctors come, or with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart. Even the cripple forgets his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. Sang on an ivy bush, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. When I am dead and in my grave, no costly tombstone will I have. Just lay me down in my native bead with a jug of punch at my head and feet.
Rob is here from Glasgow.
So it would be nice, actually, you know, it would be nice to get some feedback on how anybody, you guys there, how you're progressing with the song. Funny, when I was demoing this idea to Sean Lawless in Dundalk, who, as I said, I hope is listening, because he finally managed to sign into Facebook today. And so I was having this WhatsApp video conversation with him, and I was able to turn on my back camera on my phone and show him what I was reflecting up on a large TV screen. So those words at a jug of punch, and I was trying to show him what the auto scroll was, and then I started to sing along. As I tooraloo, and next minute he's singing away to his heart's content. And I hadn't heard Sean perform in a style. And then he must have listened to an earlier one, Mary, where there was a song we had by some guy, and we were asking the name of the song. And then Sean said, oh yeah, I remember it from another song called Cupid. So that's the hint of a hit made by a guy called, a hit was called Cupid. So
if anybody out
I didn't
there
know the song, but John said, like, you know, you're from a younger age group than me, Liam, so you wouldn't know it. But the cat's part of it was, he sang like a showman. I could have seen him in that smart suit of his in his 20s, strolling around the streets in a dog with that neat, lawless haircut on him, you know. So when I hope you're listening, Sean and Mary, and I wish you as well, and look after yourselves in the meantime. We're going to go for Scarborough Fair.
So before that, Natalie from West Germany says, that lifted up the mood. Anne Enright, welcome again, Anne. Mary from Newbridge, we missed you for the last few nights. Hope you're all well down there.
Yeah, so keep well, and the most important, look at sing along. That's the whole idea. The real issue here is to get singing with each other. As a Keith Paddy Beefy Burton had made some really interesting videos where he has himself playing. Videoing himself playing along with this and with different instruments are fantastic. Say Ray Atchison was doing the same both with his guitar and with the bar on, etc. So we just hope you're having as much fun. Look at, for us, the time flies when we're doing this and we have a bit of fun.
Patrick Callahan is watching from California. I think Patrick, you might let us know where you are. I think you might be somewhere near San Fran, maybe in.
Well, look, we're delighted. We know it's probably just somewhat after lunchtime there in California, so. You know, we have this shared experience throughout the world of this wave of blight on our landscape around. But look, at this is one opportunity we can have to do something positive in this. Mm-hmm. We're going to go and sing Scarborough Fair now. Okay, I'll
Patrick,
go with it
anyway. Let us know who's watching with you. Is your mother Betty there from Athea in Limerick? Okay.
We're trying to play it open.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to one who lived there. She once was a true love of mine. Tell her. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Without no seam, nor fine needle work, then she'll be a true love of mine. Tell her to find me an acre of land. Parsley, sage, rosemary, beneath the salt water and the sea strand, then she'll be a true love of mine. Tell her to reap it with a sickle of love. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Then gather it all. Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine.
So Ruth in Letterkenny is out there with her cauldron, mixing up all these herbs and sending them toward our friends and family to keep away the COVID-19. And what is she doing? I suppose black pepper oil and all sorts. I don't know what's in them at all, but we're meant to use them every morning.
So there'll be all sorts of witchcraft and potions and lotions emerging in the Western world now. It's been happening in the East for a long time. But
so it's called a non-pharmaceutical intervention, Ruth.
Well, this is an NPI, or intervention is certified NPI, okay? Non-pharmaceutical intervention for mental wellness, okay? So,
Kemi Kearney.
How many days have we been at this? It just seems like.
Kemi Kearney says hello to Kathy Anderson.
It seems doing the 40 days fast or something like that. Anyway.
Oh,
the Black Velvet Band's going to be our next song.
So Patrick Callahan is from Fremont in California. Anybody know where that is? Have we been there?
I'll just have a quick look. We just have a
we'll
check.
We'll have a look, Patrick.
Haven't done this for a couple of days, guys. So again, probably because people haven't been telling us where they're from. But I think it's a lovely, you know, if I had this, it's Fremont, CA, California. So there we are, Patrick. We're on to you already.
Let's see, are you waving at us, Patrick? Come on.
So there we are. We just close this down a little. We see in the world, the big bad world. Okay, so for everybody else, we'll tell you where we are in a moment. You show me yours and I'll show you mine. But you can see there, Fremont.
Show me.
Okay, so somewhere in California,
that little red dot
halfway
there.
Between San Francisco, I reckon, is it? And
it's actually just south of San Francisco,
Fremont, all right?
Yeah.
So beside San Jose.
And in a little bit.
Well, funny, I thought it was inland, but that's fantastic. It's on San Francisco Bay, which almost looks like it.
It's on the bay.
It's almost like a seawater lake. Patrick, you obviously have a lovely place on the bay there. Again, we've been to San Francisco.
We'll
been
be
there
over
a couple
to see
of
you
times,
soon,
but,
Patrick. Yeah.
So just look, please do let us know where you are. It's nice for us to know that there are people all over the world who have, you know, can enjoy a similar bit of music. You can see as we move through the center of the States, we often have friends from Pittsburgh and down south
here
in Nashville. Nashville, and where is Nashville along here?
Nashville, Tennessee.
But where's Tennessee? Where's Tennessee?
Louisiana.
Oh yeah, it's over
here.
God, it's amazing. But anyway, see, it's easy for us. We know where we are. We're just this little pokey, little yokey, this little dog here. See this fella here.
We should look at Derbyshire in England as well to see where Roe is.
Never mind Derbyshire. What about Suffolk, Mary?
Suffolk.
Right. Now, do you know where Suffolk is? Where that?
It's somewhere... Suffolk. No, it's over near London, I think.
Surrey, Maidstone, Suffolk.
Sussex and Suffolk.
Anyway, that's our person for tonight, guys.
Yeah, okay.
But we would anybody else out there.
Tell us where it is and we'll have another
look. We're
going
to do the Black Velvet Band now, okay? So again, how you find these, just for those who are not with us before, and we're delighted if you've joined us and hope that you like this, just having a bit of fun doing this, are the books that we're talking about
Hello, John Coyle. John Coyle is here with us.
How are you, John? Yeah, how are you getting on today? I suppose... You know, it's funny, we wouldn't see you now whether you're a long way away from us or a short way away from us. But that's what the songbooks physically look like. When all this finishes, you'll have to do your exercises by carrying 3.5 kilos of these lovely songs, which in big font and lovely layout and print. The books open up beautifully and you can write all over them, etc. That's the beauty of, obviously, physical books, but again... We combine that with these. So these are PDFs of these same books with hyperlinks, etc. in them. And they're available for free distribution or whatever. We put these books together. A labour of love over the last 2 years. We'd be delighted that people would use them. It's the Black Velvet Band and Book 30. So we just go through on an A to Z. You'll see a lot of those songs as we're passing through them that you might say, God, I like there's a song, Mary from the Low. May You Never, me and Bobby McGee. Lovely, a lot of beautiful songs there. So do point out to Mary, send Mary a message and just suggest songs that we can do. Look, we put in a number, then we'll see how we get on after that.
Onion Europe says, I think you have a nephew in Suffolk. I don't know about him. You might let me know who he is, Onya.
The Holy Ground, isn't it?
John Cooley is watching.
What have you done? The Black Velvet Band, sorry.
Black Velvet Band?
Yeah, I'm just going through. I have to go and find these... So again, out of 500 songs, you'll see lots of songs you'd like to play. And I'm hoping that, you know, they give you an idea of, it's not black, is it?
Ray is from Skerries. Ray McCarthy is from Skerries in County Dublin.
So just follow along the chords.
Was it Natalie or who asked for this? One of your...
So we'll play it, we'll try it with the capo in two positions up, see how it goes, all right?
Oh, my capo, hang on, I got my capo. Two. That's why I have to...
Decline there.
Decline, yeah. You know the way you decline when you get... Yeah, okay.
Okay. Right, the capo in position two. In a neat little town they call Belfast, an apprentice to trade I was bound. Oh, many. Sorry, we just push it up to three. Sorry, it needs to be a one up. So, sorry, start again.
We
push it up to three. Again, we have to try and sing what works with us. So, apologies if it's too high or too low for you. But you're going to play these back again in any key you wish later on. Just move the capo up and down.
In a neat little town they call Belfast, an apprentice to trade I was bound. Oh, many an hour sweet happiness have I spent in that neat little town. Then a sad misfortune came over me, which caused me to stray from the land, far away from my friends and relations, betrayed by the Black Velvet Band.
Now that's the chorus, everybody join in.
Her eyes they shone like diamonds, I thought she was queen of the land. And her hair it shone over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. I took a stroll down Broadway, not intending to stay very long, where I met with a frolicsome damsel as she came a-tripping along. She was both fair and Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. So you thought she was the queen of the land. And her hair had hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. I took a stroll with this fair maid and a gentleman passing us by. Well, I knew that she ventured to do it of him by the look in her roguish black eye. A gold watch she took from his pocket and placed it right into my hand. And the very first thing that I said, that says to her black velvet band, her eyes they shone like diamonds. I thought she was queen of the land. And her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band.
The next.
Before the judge and the jury, next morning I had to appear. The judge, he says to me, young man, the case against you is quite clear. And 7 long years is your sentence. You're going to Ban Demon's Land, far away from your friends and companions, betrayed by a black velvet band. Her eyes they shone like diamonds. I thought she was queen of the land. And her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet. So come on, you jolly young fellows, a warning you can't take from me. Whenever you're out on the town, me lads, beware of them pretty Colleen. She'll fill you with whiskey and porter until you're unable to stand. And the very next thing that you know, you're landed in Ban Demon's Land. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds. I thought she was queen of the land. And her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band.
I think both Natalie and Anya asked for that song.
Yeah, I hope you like
maybe
those songs.
It was
again,
I'm not sure.
I think a lot, the great thing about a lot of these songs is they're real sing-along songs. If you notice, songs with choruses and sing them in between each verse, they carry you through. And there's always a little, those songs are lovely because there's a bit of a story in them, usually a bit of a moral in that story as well.
So Anne Simmons, hello Anne, how are you? Say hello to Annette from Donegal.
Hi Annette.
From Anne in Donegal.
From Anne.
Oh. She says, love your show.
Well, you know, the whole thing is that we might be making a holy show of ourselves. But this is, I mean, we often ask ourselves, and we did this a couple of weeks ago before Paddy's Day, we thought, how can we participate in any sort of communal action or intervention in relation to this? So we said, look, we had been experimenting with live streaming our weekly get-together sing-song because Mary had a number of friends and relations in the States and they love the Irish brogue and all the rest. So that's how we did this.
Are you there,
so
Peggy?
We said, let's try and do this during every day at 7 o'clock in the evening. And it's not like any of the other, like a lot of the other musical performs, really good musicians are out there singing songs and they're singing to you and it's lovely and all the rest. But if you're missing the point, if that's what's going on, you really want to listen to other people singing. This is about you singing along and, you know, I think engaging in the songs in a way. Again, I think it's lovely when people send a note and Mary can reflect on it. But what memories do these songs?
So
all songs carry memories. So yeah.
Here's one, Maria Fordham. She used to be in a little community choir with a homeless charity. Great memories of two homeless guys singing solo verses of Black Velvet Band in a Christmas concert which Terry Waite attended. It was fab. We met Terry Waite actually in, where was it in Scotland?
Edinburgh, I think, wasn't
it? In Edinburgh, we were crossing the street, we were at the traffic lights waiting to cross the street. And I looked up at this man, my God, he was so tall. We did say hello to him and he said hello back.
He said, hello, I'm Mary Clear, have you heard of me? He says, I called in to see Clint Eastwood when I was in Carmel in California, when he was mayor there, but he didn't. He wasn't there to see me. So
we do things here? Like that. We're like, Patricia Prenti is
we're
here.
Like, where's Willie or something like that, you know?
Patricia Prenti and Mark McCormick are here from...
Hi, guys. So
sure,
we're going to sing the Galway Girl now, okay?
Well, are we going to try singing the Galway Girl?
I'm going to try and sing the Galway Girl.
Who asked
again,
for this?
So I know, Patricia, sorry if we didn't make it last night. We'd be knackered after this, really, because we're running trying to catch up with ourselves and waiting for see what's going to fall go wrong next. But anyway.
He is a big guy. he is a big guy, Maria. Yeah,
he's a tough. So again, for those of you who would know Terry Wade, he was
hostage.
Minister of one of the Church of Ireland, Church of England, Church of something anyway. But he was held hostage, I think, in Lebanon. I think he might have been held with Brian Keenan from Belfast.
For quite a time, Maria, you know that. Let us know, will you?
But never carried with him any animosity towards. And since if you think what an enemy is, I mean, COVID is our enemy, but there's no point in feeling angry at him. It's not going to do much good. So we kind of redirect our anger in positive and useful ways. So if you think we're angry singing, that's our version of it. Anyway, we're going to do the Galway Girl. Yes, we have to find out.
Who sings the Galway Girl?
I think it's Steve Earle.
Earle. So
and Mundy and lots of other people.
Well, so some time ago, I'm not sure how long ago it was, but Steve Earle, he recorded this in Galway outside on the street somewhere. And if you
I think it was Mundy who did that. I think.
I don't know. Anyway.
Well, no, Steve Earle.
I believe it was Steve Earle. So my sister, who lives in Galway City.
It doesn't matter anyway, really. Facts are kind of irrelevant here.
My sister Helen is in the choir that sang along with them.
So at least we get your sister's name right, okay?
Well, Helen or Eileen, one right. Or the other, yeah.
But we get that right, and never mind whether Steve Earle was singing along with her or Mundy. They were lucky, isn't that right?
They were very lucky, yeah.
Yeah, there was hundreds. I mean, it was what do you call that street? West Street, is it? Or
I'm not sure. It was a
shop. You know, the narrow street going down through the...
It wasn't Shop was Street, no. I don't know where it was. I don't know where it was. Was it Salt Hill, or was it...
No, I think it was in the city centre, but there was hundreds of people all singing that song together, you know.
But she's right up front, you can see her.
God, you know, I hit a bit of song.
We're not sure about this now, so hang on.
Well, so we'll try and play it open and see how we get on. Well, I took this stroll on the old long walk on an AIA. I met a little girl and we stopped to talk on the facts of the AIA. And I asked her, friend, what's a fella to do? Cause her hair was black and her eyes were blue. And I knew right then I'd be taking the twirl around the Salt Hill prom with the Galway Girl. We were halfway there when the rain came down on the day I. She asked me there at a flat downtown on the soft IAIA. And I asked you, friend, what's a fella to do? Cause her hair was black and her eyes were blue. And I knew right then I'd be taking a twirl. When I woke up, I was all alone on the AIA, with a broken heart and a ticket home on South Line AIA. And I asked you, girl, what's a fella to do? Cause your hair was black and her eyes were blue. I've traveled around, I've been all over this world, but I ain't seen nothing like a Galway Girl. When I woke up, I was all alone on the AIA, with a broken heart and a ticket home on a science of the AIA. And I asked you, friend, what's a fella to do? Cause her hair was black and her eyes were blue. I've traveled around, I've been all over this world, cause I ain't seen nothing like a Galway Girl.
Won't be asking for that again in a hurry.
Well, no, look at it again.
We haven't done it.
Well, it's not, see, sorry, just to explain, this is important, but we've explained the ethos of the book, mm-hmm. and it's very important, because if you're a ukulele player, for example, all uki groups play always in, they don't tend to use ukuleles, and that's understandable, because they play in mass groups, and they just have the song set in keys, and the keys suit particular voices, and maybe not other voices. We tried to pitch these in keys where you could transform the chords fairly easy, and you could use a capo to raise the pitch. Or another technique, which was to, so for example, if we just try this again here in the key of C, so that's in D. So if every time you see, just an example, and again from a learning point of view, we've learned to become quite used to this. If we say, well, that's a bit high, let's drop it by, let's drop it down to the key of C. You just take every letter, the chords are in bold, italicized brackets there. Take every letter and go step back one. So a D becomes a C, a G becomes an F, an A becomes a G. So when you come to a chord, just step back one letter on it. So in that first verse, it'll go from C to F, it'll go from C to F to C, and then it'll go to G back to C. And if I just play it like that, just so we play just a verse in the chorus,
can
right?
We just do that one.
And the B minor in the chorus then becomes an A minor, all right? So everything else is, so. Well, I took a stroll on an old long walk on a D-I-A-I-A. I met a little girl and I stopped to talk on a fine soft day. Look, we're pretty obviously exposed doing this here now. We're just singing and making fools of ourselves or whatever. But if we were singing this together ourselves, and it depends. I can only say for me that different times my voice would be able to sing in maybe, you know, might be able to sing a bit higher, sing a bit lower. Depends on what's been going on for me that day. And also, I'm sure if I took the trouble of training my voice, I could, you know, do my... Da 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 da, etc. But anyway, I mean, look, at the whole idea of this thing was that if you were in a kitchen somewhere where there was a party on, you heard people singing in the sitting room, and you've ever lived that existence, this is supposed to hopefully remind you of that.
So Anya says in London, she says Ed Sheeran recorded his Galway Girl in Shop Street. Louis Brown said, I think he, I don't know, is that Liam? Mistook me for a radiator, whatever that means. I don't get that. Mary Gogon says, there seems to be a problem with the transmission. Anybody else having a problem? I think we're okay here. Mary, Rosie Bradley is here. Rosie called Bradley.
Yeah, so just to say that if at different times, depending on your down speed or up speed, you may have interference. Because look, you can imagine the load that's on the internet at the moment at all times, especially this time of the evening. Especially with lots of gamers playing high speed, high resolution games, and everybody watching Netflix and Prime Video and all that sort of stuff. So anyway, you can always play it again later on if it suits you. Can play this at any time. Especially our wish is that people would play this back and play along with the songs. Actually, I've been practicing. I've got a mandolin and I play it by ear. Really, I play. But I've been just plucking away at the mandolin, listening to the background and thinking of what Keith Batty Beefy Burton did. And I've listened to some of his ones and then I'm playing along with him. So it's just another way of passing time, a diversion. And, you know, if you take it on this Japanese idea of improvement, iterative improvement called Kaizen, a little bit at a time, marginal gains, as the man says.
So Jürgen Braun and Renata.
Renata. And my apologies for having forgotten
yes.
your name.
Anyway.
It was just that I had Jürgen's contact on Facebook. So we hope you're well. I believe
up
in northern Germany.
I can't remember the name of the place.
I think you're up in northern Germany. Let us know exactly where you are. And we wish you well. And, you know, we hear some sort of positive news in terms of how the virus progression is slowing down in Germany. So we wish you well. That's, I mean, in spirit, we can all support each other in that
sense.
So
Inés Rodriguez says, can't join today, cleaning day, just listening while I disinfect the house.
Oh,
Susan Wilms is watching from California. She's somewhere near San Fran as well.
So this goes out to our friend Brian Cleary, who spends his time
disinfecting
everything.
The postman.
His wife, the dogs, everything. He goes around with a steamer. He steams everybody up and down. So keep it up, Brian. We're going to try and sing the Holy Ground.
Hello, Nancy Cleary from Pittsburgh.
So while Mary's talking, I'm just going to try and set up on page 372 of book one. So again, go through the book in your PDF. I'll just show you here. The beauty of this book also is that, you know, you might find maybe you haven't heard these songs before, because we got them from all sorts of eclectic backgrounds. And again, in this song, you'll see we've posted it in two different keys. And of course, I don't know which one we're going to play. But the point is that at the end of every song, there's a link to a YouTube video. If you just hit that hyperlink, then it will bring you off to somewhere on YouTube that somebody is playing that song. So just give me a moment. I see where we're going to do it. I can't remember a song. Oh, how do you sing this song?
No, that's it.
It was the other song we sang earlier, wasn't it? Leaving of Liverpool.
No. So.
Yeah, I think you're wrong.
Do this. You're the girl I did adore, and still I live in hopes to see.
So the great thing about, there's so many songs here, and we try to sing them.
Was I right, guys?
No, Mary started it. You to you, my Dinah.
Okay,
a thousand times
we could always sing it like that.
That's it.
Let's try it like that.
The leaving of Liverpool, Mary. Maybe. So anyway, look at so we often have to go to the chorus and try and remember
what
the song
is. Well, if we do the chorus first.
Girl, I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see holy ground once more. Fine girl, you are. I think, yeah, but Poppy would be able to sing that up in two up. Let's try. Still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more.
Fine girl, yeah.
Okay, so we know what we're doing. We're playing it just as you see it, except the capos and position. Actually, you're going to put it on position one. All right, just put it in position one.
One.
And it'll suit us better. Okay. So again, I want to repeat. This is not a prescriptive or definitive pitch or anything to be singing, and we really encourage you to sing along, and then afterwards go back and find a key that works with you, and on your own little notes write them down. If we were working with physical books, we would write these on the notes and say, here's the key and the pitch and the fret position that we're going to play.
How could you do that to me? Kevin Stars is watching, and Louis, will you mind tell us what you mean by the radiator, please? Thank you.
Okay, so we're going to play fret position one. How are you, Kevin? So Kevin did a wonderful, we did a Zoom call, which I recorded 2 days ago. Kevin had gone through the whole cycle of online shopping using Tesco, the conglomerate. So I presume they're doing it all over the world. They're obviously a multinational where you can order your food in online. And particularly for those people, those of us who have been advised to cocoon for a lengthy period of time. I think it's a very important skill to learn. That's in no way to take away from the wonderful work that's been done by local shops and suppliers in many, many communities, including our own. They're well ahead of the curve in terms of making local solutions. But we were talking about a global, scalable operations management approach. And Kevin had gone through a whole cycle of shopping in through Tesco, and he talked me through it, and we put it up as a public service initiative for people who might want to learn about how to do it and the catches about what happens if there's not stuff in stock when they order it, and can I believe that my stuff will be delivered and I won't be overcharged and all. So we had a good experience. So again, thanks Kevin, it was wonderful. And again, I think it was most important to get it up there and let people see. And we're reaching out here to men's sheds in Ireland, England and Australia, who normally have the fun and camaraderie of your friends. Let's try and, you know, think of those times as we're singing along. So it's capo in position one. Right, Mary?
Okay.
Adieu to you, my Dinah.
we shall sail the South Sea over, and then return for shore to see again the girls we love and the holy ground once more.
Fine girl you are.
Now we got the pits.
Wow.
You're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more.
Fine girl you are.
I see the storm rising, I see it coming soon, and the sky it is so clouded you can scarcely see them. Big pink moon tonight,
yeah.
And the good old ship she was tossing about. The rigging was all torn, and still I sit in hopes to see the holy ground once more.
Fine girl, yeah.
You're the girl I do adore, and still I live in hopes to see the holy ground once more.
Fine girl, yeah.
And now the storm is over, and we are safe on shore. We'll drink and toast in a holy ground, and the girl that we adore. We will drink strong ale and porter, and make the rafters roar. And when our money is all spent, we'll go to sea for. Girl, I do adore, and still I live in hope to see the holy ground once more.
Fine girl, you are. Oh, right.
It's funny, I see a lot of people putting stuff up on Facebook at the moment, setting out what the plan is when all this incarceration is over. So I suppose that song carry some of the visions of all that.
So here's a memory. Anya then says, the Holy Ground used to listen on the radio and shout out, fine girl you are. So the 15-minute sponsored programme, 15,
by the Waltons.
On RTE, that's where her early music education came from.
I wonder, was that the Waltons? Was it? Just, I might say that I remember the home of music. So Waltons is a music shop in Dublin. And I think it was. They used to sponsor... They used to sponsor a radio program after the 1 o'clock news or something every day when I was a kid. And I remember when I was a student in college, I think they had a shop up beyond where the Gresham Hotel is, up that road up there, up to the right-hand side of Colossus, we're up there. And I remember I went in and they were getting rid of books of old pamphlet songs, I still have them, they're all grayed out. Beautiful old collection of songs from many, many years ago. And I still have those in my little box. And I'm sure there are gems and jewels in that as well. But I think that might... And there was a sort of a jingle or something for the Walton. Maybe somebody can remember it out there.
And so then I'm sure some of you remember the little man coming, kind of a little gypsy, I don't know what they call him, like a roving minstrel or something, selling sheet music, selling songs. So the thing about the radiator, by the way, about the radiator,
what song is that?
Terry Waits was held hostage for four or five years in a cell, handcuffed to a radiator.
Handcuffed to a radiator, that's correct.
So Maria Fordham has good memories of singing Holy Ground in the van with my Uncle Pat from Newport and all our family. Fine girl you are.
What song is it again? Hey Mr. Dream Seller, what's that song? It's in the book. Meet Me on the Corner. Let's have a look and we can find a song, Meet Me on the Corner, right? It's just that Mary was talking about the people who used to sell songs, the sheet sellers.
Songs,
that's how music was distributed. It was way before Napster and iTunes and all that stuff. Hey, what's it, Mr. Dream? Meet Me on the Corner. Let's see if we have
Kathy, we know you're there. We know you're there still.
Oh, yeah.
Is Paul and Peter and Paul, are they with you? Walton's was in North Frederick Street. And the punchline was, if you do sing a song... If you do sing a song, make it an Irish song. One, two, three, maybe.
Yeah, we'll try this on.
That's nice.
Okay, so can't remember. Lindisfarne, that's the band that sang this. Lindisfarne, gorgeous, gorgeous song. So let's try and see if we can do this, right? Yeah. Again, you may not know these songs, guys. Some of them you may like us, you may have heard them say, God, I'd love to have that song.
We're so going
to
do the night.
Songs are there. If you don't know a song, you know, that YouTube link at the bottom of every song in the PDF, and we encourage you, get the PDF. If you have a problem getting it, Nigel, only had a problem, or had a problem getting it, and he contacted us through the message board or whatever, made sure we got it to him. But you can download it if you sign up to the group. We'll approve you, as many people are coming in every day, and just download the PDFs, circulate them among your friends. I mean, we had the idea of doing this as an open source project. Open source isn't the correct technical name, but if you think of the Creative Commons open source, I mean, all we're doing is adding some sort of measure of presentation to the songs, beautiful songs, and lucky for us to be able to experience them. Right, but three frets on.
Hey, Mr. Dream Seller, where have you been? Tell me, have you dreamed? I can see. I came along just to bring you this song. Can you spare one dream for me? You won't let me, and you'll soon forget. So at your sleeve, I'm asking you if I can fix a wrong for you, for your dreams are all I believe. Meet me on the corner where the lights are coming on, and I'll be there. I promise I'll be there. Down the empty streets where we'll disappear into the dawn, if you bundles of rags and reminders, and spread your wares on the ground. Well, I've got time if you're feeling right. I'm just hanging around. Meet me on the corner when the lights are coming on, and I'll be there. I promise I'll be there. Down the empty streets will disappear into the dawn. You have dreams enough to share. Hey, Mr. Dream Seller, where have you been? Tell me, have you dreamed? I can see. Dream along just to bring you this song.
I love that song. I think that's a magical song. And you know what it is in this period that we're in now? You know, if you look at the black and white and you see it and you say to yourself, how come between Valentine's Day and Easter Sunday in this planet, the paradigm on many, many levels has been a multi-dimensional paradigm shift has actually happened, and the rest of us, we're all just trying to catch up with it. The ship has moved, it's turned into, it's metamorphosized as Kafka's Gregor into something else. We don't know what that else is. But you know, one of the things that keeps everybody going is the concept of the dream. You know, we sang Christy Moore's The Voyage, and again, we're on a voyage somewhere, wherever that is. And all, it seems to me like the characters in the book, The Voyage, you know, and Brad Pitt, and they're all down the proletariat, and the Irish emigres are all down in the hold, the poor people. But they're all playing and singing and dancing away. So that's all you can do. That's what we can do, this, guys. You know, it's fagerling. We can do this.
To Michael Sansom, you're very welcome to Meitheal Ceol. Please let us know where you're from. He says, and thank you very much for your kind words. You're a delightful couple who sing together with a warmth. Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you.
But more importantly, Michael, I think throughout the people who are watching this, I mean, I think we know from talking to people that they're enjoying singing along. That's really what this is about. You know, our history about this is Meitheal Ceol is a process which we've been involved in for the last 3 or 4 years, generating the idea of that we could go around and meet people and have a common book, a song, a couple of song books that we could sing from. So about five, these books, these words are coming from song books. There was about 500 songs with the chords and the words provided. You know, just sit there and go along. You wanted to do a song.
Well, I do, but did we do Go Lassie Go? There's one song that Ruth has asked for.
Okay, so we're going to do Will You Go Lassie Go again, another
trans-global,
motivational, goodwill song, all right? Because it does ask, we are all going on this journey together, so let's have a bit of
Nancy
fun.
Nancy Cleary and Edwin, hello. Nancy and Chuck, Nancy Cleary in Pittsburgh, and Edwin, hello. Nancy and Chuck in Nashville, hello. Summer. Yeah, this is a lovely song, I like this a lot. One, maybe.
Hold on. Oh, it's summertime. No, we're singing in one, right? So
one.
It said, put it up in capo position one with the chords as you see in front. Oh, the summertime is coming. And the trees are sweetly blooming. And the wild mountain vine grows around. So one of the problems here is when you're in the middle of a song, then you're sort of half committed to it in a way. But I mean, the other thing it seems to me is when you're trying to sing a song and you're projecting it, you might sing it at a higher tone or pitch. But ultimately, we're all singing in our own houses wherever we are. Some of you are watching on your own. Some of you are watching a couple of you at a time, two or three of you with friends, family. Well, you want the friends, but unless they're staying with you all the time. And maybe some of you have young kids there with you, and those kids have not grown up in this world. They've grown up in a world where they've lived on their phones and their tablets and their Xboxes and all the rest. And my own sense is that a lot of their music has been piped down into them, or they're following the Voice of England or something, the Voice of Ireland or whatever. And the problem with all that stuff is it's all very perfected by technology and everything else, and the big production system behind them. And if you listen to any of this, the well-known celebrities playing from the songs in garages and things like that unplugged, you'll probably be surprised at how ordinary they sound. But the important thing about that is that it should encourage you to say, look, I can have it, pass a song here. Mm-hmm. And I should make yourself the promise that whatever you're in a sing song, whatever again, that you'll encourage ordinariness. I've said to you, Brian Mulligan from Sligo today put up a post which is, you know, saying propagandizing the value of adequacy as against perfection. I mean, one of the problems about perfection, which is, you know, for a certain group of people who are seeking excellence, that's fine. But in a world which rejects everything except perfection, then adequacy is left behind. And all we're trying to be is adequate and have a bit of fun, and we're enjoying it. We're trying to share that joy with you. We found this a joyous experience. And Mary wanted to do, what song did you want?
The Night Visiting Song.
So again, look at it. If you feel like a song.
Natalie says the last song suited our voice as well.
Yeah, so again, for you, if you're there somewhere, wherever you're singing, please try and find a pitch that works with you. And just enjoy it. I mean, that's the important thing. You know, none of us know where the other side of this tunnel is.
So Natalie, when you come back to Ireland, she loves Donegal.
Again, here's one of the songs that again for us are in two keys, and so it was a bit of a running around to see where to play this song.
Mary Fay, you're welcome. Let us know where you're from, please. Yeah. Hi, it's up.
Well, I don't know. I must away. So we'll play this in the key of G, as you see. And again, apologies, but there's no other way around us at the moment of having to shift up and down and create a bit of a break in the singing. But and I know that Ruth in Letterkenny there, he always sings the last lines of these songs a bit different than us.
Yeah.
That's fine.
And Karen. But,
and
Karen and
Omar. Anyway, it's just our interpretation of the song. Luke Kelly, although we learned it from
Karen
Doust, who's originally from Toronto, living now in Tyrone, but I realised Luke Kelly, in fact, made a beautiful rendition of this originally, and I had heard it then from, I didn't appreciate that I'd seen this by Nuala Kennedy, originally from Dundalk, but living in Scotland, doing a beautiful rendition of this song, which I discovered later on. So, like in memory of all those testimonies, let's enjoy this song.
So Mary Fay is from Dublin. Welcome, Mary.
So, capo up and two.
I must away now. I can no longer tarry. This morning's tempest, I have to cross. Small clouds began to grow.
sorry, I just have a... These songs are all shooting away past us here.
Kathy Anderson says, hello Marie from Castle Derg. Marie is our daughter-in-law. Natalie says, I have to buy a new instrument for going to Ireland.
So we were talking about dreams earlier on, and I just...
John O'Dreams, is it? Any dream will do.
Well, let's try this. I might do. Let's look at it. So, this is the song, I think, from Joseph and his amazing Technicolor dream.
What do you call the man? Tony, what was his name?
Tony Kenny, was
Kenny,
it?
Kenny, I think, yeah.
So we're going to play it open as it was. Another lovely sing-along song. So let's have a go. And just let's close your eyes there and dream of better times. You know, I often think people used to be asking Christy Moore when he was singing why his eyes were closed all the time. And he was saying that, you know, when his eyes were closed, he'd be painting video image or visual images across the inside of the eyelids. And I often think, you know, the beauty about singing songs, it can transport you to other places and other times. So that's the virtual magic about this, that, you know, while we're incarcerated in our physical bodies in this space, we can transcend all of this.
This is for you, Sean Lawless, Liam and Mary. I have been listening since 7 p.m, except for interruption from Mary L. Mary L, that's not me.
Sean Lawless, look at this. Sean Lawless can do this, and he can get online and make these comments. He can all do it. So I'm delighted, Sean, and I was saying, I presume you heard, when you might tell us in that thing, who that Cupid, who is, we had sung another song, and you remembered the song as coming from some guy who sung the song Cupid, and then your lovely dulcet tones were coming out there, and I'd say you were some suave operator with that haircut and the old Hucklebuck shoes and all on you, Sean. So anyway, good memory. So let's go with this, and in fact, We'll sing this for our common good friend Bernie Bingham, who had produced this show. I think he told me that he produced this show and Joseph and his Technicolor Dreamcoat. Would it be 30 or 40 years ago that he produced it in Prague behind the Iron Curtain, which is where he met his present wife, his one and only present wife, Viola, and who we both know well. And it's interesting, he had to... To be allowed to perform Joseph and his, present it or produce it over in Prague, he had to convince the communist regime there that there were no religious overtones or whatever to the, what do you call it?
It's called Joseph and the Amazing.
That's just an interesting song. That's where Viola met him that many times, because he happened to be there. They were in the days when people didn't travel.
I saw that in London.
Maria, well, and Bernie, obviously, and Maria, okay?
I close my eyes, drew back the curtain to see for certain. I thought I knew, far, far away, someone was weeping, but the world was sleeping, and dream will do. I wore my coat with golden lining, bright colors shining. Colors fade.
Float away in songs like that.
So Sean Lawless, that was for you.
And Bernie and Viola and Maria.
Yeah. So, Connie Francis sang... this is for Nigel O'Mahony. Connie Francis sang Stupid Cupid. And Sam Cooke sang...
Sam Cooke, Sean. That's always... It was Sam
Stupid
Cooke.
Cupid and Sam Cooke sang Cupid.
Yes, it was Sam Cooke. Right. So we're going to sing an Irish song here. Somebody mentioned singing an Irish song sometime earlier. And we'll have a go at this song.
Well, actually, somebody asked for Peggy Lettermore. Anya asked for Peggy Lettermore.
Well, we're going to sing this one here right
now. Okay, that's fine. That's no problem. No problem. We'll do that tomorrow night.
I just came across the songs here. So, so again, for those of you who are not maybe familiar with the language or from abroad or whatever, but I think... So it's really about the phonetics and the sound of the words. again, I'm not so used to singing these songs. I would have heard them and sung them when I was a kid, but I think what I like about them is the harshness of the consonants, like that first verse, Shentru yer nachmisha, nachmisha, Shentru yer nachmisha, banfajin. So I just love the way they are, and it's a bit like the guttural sound of the German language when you're singing with those songs or something. I just happen to love them. So anyway, we'll try and have a go at it. So
is this the one where he goes to Clifton, isn't it? And Ballinaboy.
Yeah.
I like this. Yeah.
So we're going to play it in capo position one. And again, a couple of the first part, the corfa, that word corfa stands for chorus. And it's sung after every verse. So this is a song about a guy or a woman actually singing a song, and she's wishing that she was some other fella called Pa Jean's woman or wife or whatever. She's, she's wishing that that were the case, and she's wishing, but she's just saying how she would traipse all over the world to try and get on with him, to get off with him, and she's wishing bad cess to the... to the wife of, like, so in that verse there, she talks, the Gumrishar the Kossa, may your legs be broken and your bones be broken. And then at the end, then she's a bit pissed off when he doesn't come to her, and she throws her shoes after him down the road. So that's what it's like.
So bad cess is like a curse. She's put a curse
bad
on
bad cess to your black velvet band. That's where the word came into my head from tonight earlier on.
Yeah,
so anyway,
that's a good one.
Cap 1-1. Shen through your not misha, not misha, shen through your not misha, van faji. Shen through your not misha, not misha, shen van and I'll give a kalcha. Rye in the dive, the dive, rye in the dive, the faji. Rye in the dive, the dive. She throws the shoes after him.
Cop me my frog and my frog and cop me my frog and 8:40. Cop me my frog and my frog as the cop me the bween as the solar. Chance through your not mission, not mission, through your not mission and falling. Chain through your not mission, not mission and man at the egg of a culture. Chant through your not mission, not mission, through your not mission, man falling. Chant through your not mission, not mission, and then a dying day culture.
That's lovely. That's for you, Anya. So Anya knows where Bell and the Boy is and all of that. She knows all around that area.
Yeah, so that Aon of the Clock on is Clifton, is where Mary
That's where
grew
I come
up,
from.
Is,
yeah.
In Clifton, in west of 50 miles west of Galway. But that song, when I sing it, I suppose the person who stands out for me singing that song has always been Donal Lunny, who's been one of with almost so many bands, including the Bounty Band and, Moving Hearts, and obviously Planksty, etc. But while I don't think Donal Lunny has a particularly good voice as a singer, I don't think he would claim to have. He wouldn't have been a lead singer, but he sings that song, I think, particularly well.
So, Nick Louis Brown says Nick Drake sang Pink Moon. We don't know Pink Moon, but we know Blue Moon.
It was just, I was listening somewhere on a media day and I'm being told that tonight is unique.
The largest,
and it's a pink full moon, but it's not pink.
But it's going to be the largest this year.
But I didn't know how it got them.
Brian Laverty, hello Brian, how are you? Are you in your tidy workshop there? Yeah. Bella Doohan is watching. And Natalie says, wow, another beautiful Irish song, love it.
We're going to try this one in fret 2 while we're at it. We're on a roll. Blueberry Hill. Right, fret 2.
Oh,
right?
Diego. Come on.
I found my thrill on Blueberry Hill. On Blueberry Hill. When I
Well, Brian, you said Brian Laverty had dropped in there. There's a song that Brian Laverty introduced us to. I think it's Punch and Judy, man, is it?
Oh, yes.
I wonder, can we sing it, Brian? But I remember we used to sing this and said, we have to get the words and the chords of this. There's a lovely, lovely song. I'm not sure if we... Probably I'll try to sing this, can't even remember. I mightn't remember. Punch and Judy.
When this
man,
is all over, Brian, you must come out again and have a few songs with us.
Yeah, we'll...
And Cahill and the others.
But it's much so, keep Brian does some lovely performance. He started the live stream recently and playing, and lovely to listen to, okay?
So where are we putting
the
people?
Down the lanes and foggy chimneys.
Down the lanes and foggy chimneys.
That's
high,
you need to be
a bit high. Yeah. So we'll try it in D, it might be a bit high for the anyway. If you don't know the song, I think you'll love it after this. So we're just playing it open like this.
Down the lanes of foggy chimneys. seaside town. Strides the east wind like a dragon, strewing leaves of ragged brown. Winter's planting icicles along the barren shore, and the punch and dewy man is gone forever. Mr. Punch and Dewy.
No. No.
Mr. Punch and
Dewy. No. Brian, help him.
Mr. Punch and Dewy man. Mr. Punch and Judy man, bring back my childhood land of summer. In the meadows by the river, where the elm and willow stand, silver mist is creeping down to lullaby the sleeping land. Through the bare and blackened branches, swallows fly no more, and the punch and dewy man is gone forever. Mr. Punch and dewy man, bring back my childhood land of summer. Slot machines and penny arcades jingle jangle on the pier. Gone the sound of laughing children fading with the dying year. Through the town he wanders in the misty autumn, and the Punch and Dewy man is gone forever. Mr. Punch and Judy man, bring back my childhood land of summer.
No.
It's a lovely verse.
Yeah.
Punchinello, Punchinello, where have you and Judy gone? Gone to join the swelling ranks of things that we look back upon. Memory can conjure you from dreams of summer day, but the Punch and Dewy man's gone forever. Mr. Punch and Dewy man, bring back our childhood land of summer. Mr. Punch and Dewy man, bring back our childhood.
That's beautiful, and thank you, Brian, for introducing us to that most gorgeous song. So look, at time has flown by, it's 5 now, we're going to leave it. Said last song every night is our typical, our usual lovely way of saying goodbye to each other, parting glass, wherever I can find it here. Boom, boom, boom. Where is it? Sorry, I'm stroking across different apps here in the hope of finding the parting glass. And again, we have it with the possibility of, I need to put it into presenter mode, and I need to change the pace, so it's right down there at capo 4. Okay, so it's in capo 4, the parting glass. So once again, another evening, another dime, another dollar, as the fella says. Great to have everybody, whoever's there with us again. Sure, so in capo position 4, folks, all right, so please... I mean, I hope that you've enjoyed singing as well as ever. I hope the songs have brought up new memories and nice memories of that song. I think anybody who ever was around hurdy-gurdy's or fairs when you were kids, the swinging boats in Black Rock, or the bumping cars in Bray, for me, all those memories, gorgeous memories to have. And it's nice at this time to reflect on some of those thoughts. So we'll all sing this together. Little Diego here is jumping up and down on me. Come on. He says it's time to go, guys. All right, so capo position
Diego,
4.
Oh, Diego, he sticks his...
Right, come on.
Of all the money that e'er I spend, spending in good company.
Sorry, I don't know why this seems to be. Sorry, it's a goner. The fella says I can't go any quicker, but it's supposed to be going very slow. Maybe we've lost our run of ourselves. I'm trying to arrange that this thing just scrolls at the right pace, right?
Okay, again.
Of all the money I ever I spent it in good company.
And all the harm that ever I did,
alas, it was to none but me. All I've done for want of a way to memory now I can't recall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you all. If I had money enough to spend and leisure time for to sit a while, there is a fair maid in the town that sorely has my heart begun. Her rosy cheeks and ruby lips, I own she has my heart in thrall. So fill to me the parting glass. Good night and joy be with you all. Of all the comrades that e'er I had, they're sorry for my going away. And all the sweethearts that e'er I had, they'd wish me one more day to stay. But since it falls unto my lot that I should rise and you should not, I'll gently rise and I'll softly call. Good night and joy be with you all. Good night and joy be with you all.
So
we come to the end of another evening of Crack Agus Ceol, Caint Agus Cadhrúb, Coa Brú, Cinaltas to each other.
Yeah. May joy be with you all, and
so we wish everybody well, and
stay safe.
Again, those couple of hours have flown by for us. I was just thinking of someone, Paul Tracy. Just, you know, big shout out to Paul. He told me the other day the house painted from top to bottom. Some guys are so kinetic, kinesthetic, and wound up that they want to be on the go all the time. So unfortunately, you can't say to someone like Paul, say, "Look, why don't you come over and paint my place now?" So it doesn't work like that. So if you had sort of erasable paint, what you could do is just paint the wall and keep going again. Or if you had bought in gallons and gallons of magnolia, you just keep painting the walls. All right. You know what I find when we're doing this, our days fly by. Is that right, Mary?
Oh my goodness, it is.
You know, we're under pressure.
But we never even got for a walk today.
Just, we're under pressure here trying to get up here for 7 o'clock. So that's what we're going to be here. Every evening at 7 o'clock, we'll be here as long as, you know, the health is with us. We'll be here to sing songs and
before
with
we
you.
Go,
that's
we have a new person, Joe Van Tonder. You're very welcome. Welcome to Meitheal Ceol. Everybody is saying thank you. That was a lovely evening and we enjoyed it and it was relaxing and all the rest. And we enjoyed it too. I suppose we had to sit and, what is it?
we have a little picture of a little dog scooting around here in the carpet saying, come on, it's time to go. I want out for a little
I think
bit
he
of
knows that when we sing,
you know,
the parting glass, that's the
you
end.
Think this is his part.
That's
so it. Listen, till tomorrow evening, as say, singing songs 7 days a week. We feel like,
Connell,
anyway, a big wish out to all those people.
We have to say hello to Connell. He's here as well.
Connell Larkin,
yes,
you know, Connell. Singer of the Belligerent Bedfellow. So if you go onto the internet, onto YouTube and look for, certainly under my name, Liam O'Gogan, I've posted a video of Conal many, many years ago singing a song they'd written called Belligerent Bedfellows. So I hope things are well for you, Conal. I mean, Conal was the one to suggest to me that, because unfortunately he can't do a generous thing he does, he was doing every week, going down into an old folks' home and singing for them. Those people, he can't visit them anymore. So if you can bring this information to the attention of people out there, sorry, Marie, to say to Conal,
Conal, we're going to try and make a mess of Meitheal tomorrow night. That's that beautiful song that Conal introduced us to.
Yeah, a song by Johnny McAvoy about dementia. Actually, as far as I understand, from Conal who introduced us to us. So, anyway, you can see how bad we do. So anyway, look at guys, it's been great to have you along, and most importantly,
Diego,
I hope you're joining in. I hope you know more songs when you're finished. Keep practicing. All right.
Okay. Good night, Slán.
Slán. Now, if we just, okay.